My name is Dan Walsh. I led the container team for the last several years at Red Hat, working with a couple of my colleagues here who are introducing Podman Desktop. So Máirín, when you started to design Podman Desktop, what were your goals with it?
Starting out, I talked to a lot of Podman users and asked them, well, how are you using Podman? What kind of applications are you building with it? And what's your workflow look like? What's your environment looking like? And you sort of go through and like study that information and kind of get a picture of like, you know, what's a workflow that would work for most users? And then we just work towards building that into the tool.
Oh, cool. Yeah. One of the goals, I guess, when we developed this is, you know, I live in Linux, and I believe that everybody should use the Linux desktop, but turns out some people like to use other operating systems. So we wanted to set up a system where they could actually work on Macs and Windows. And you want to talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, absolutely. And that's what we wanted to provide. We wanted to bring the container tooling as well as Kubernetes closer to the developer and to the platforms that they are using, such as Mac and Windows. So we create Podman Desktop, which is providing a nice user-friendly interface that Mo contributes a lot on, which basically help you to manage your container, to interact with your containers when you are building them and when you are building your applications in a cloud-native way. And we also provide Kubernetes capabilities along with the tool that simplifies going from containers to Kubernetes objects like pods that are running natively with Podman and up to production like OpenShift, for example.
Cool. One of the things, you know, where I usually use the command line and don't use a GUI, to me it's always interesting how some users enjoy working with GUIs versus just working a command line. And you want to talk about some of the ideas of things that you think you could do better with a GUI than with a command line?
Yeah, so one of the things, for example, Podman Desktop supports multiple container engines and multiple Kubernetes environments. So the one thing you can do in the GUI that you can't really do on the command line is view across all of these different container engines and Kubernetes deployments, all of the containers in one space. So it would be really nice if you're working on an application and you have it running in like a local Podman, and then you also have it running in a specific Kubernetes environment, and like it's working in one and not the other. You can see them side by side in the same interface, go into a running terminal on each container and kind of try to diff between them. Well, what's different about this environment that it's not working here and it is there? Whereas in the command line, you're using different command lines with different arguments, and so your brain has to like translate it to a different tool, whereas you're using a GUI that sort of standardizes everything, then it feels the same, and it's just an implementation detail which container backend it's using.
All right, maybe I should try it out a little bit, is what you're
going
to say?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. You might like it. Yeah.
So one of the other things I've always found is you know, running containers over the last 10 years, most people have figured out how to run containers locally on the system or fairly quickly, and there's lots of information. But as soon as they make the leap from running containers locally to trying to run containers in something like OpenShift, that's a big step up, right? Because they have to write Kubernetes YAML and stuff like that. So how exactly does the GUI help them with that step?
So you actually, we have integrated some capabilities from Podman that allows to basically generate Kubernetes YAMLs from your containers. So you can get the deployment manifest for your containers, and you can take that and deploy that onto a Kubernetes environment.
This sounds like it has a lot of value. I'm sure people want to pay a lot of money for this. How much is it going to cost?
It's free.
Free as in open source?
Yes, free as in liberty.